Hi everybody, today we're in Swaledale, which is one of the dales in the Yorkshire Dales National Park, and it's mainly famous for its stone barns, of which we're going to see quite a few in the next coming minutes. But I'm just going to go over the bridge and walk back down to the village of Muker. Barley's with us today, but she's getting a bit old and everything's a bit of a struggle. I'll go this way. Okay. And here's one of the many barns that can be seen in the Dale. As I mentioned, Swaledale is famous for them. And they can be seen in many of the other dales, but this is where most people come to see them. And they actually served a very specific purpose. They're all built to the same style, which was cattle in the ground floor and hay stored on the first floor. And the basic principle was, it was an annual cycle. In the summer you would make hay, load it into the top of the barn, and as winter approaches you'd bring your cattle in from the fields and pop them into the ground floor, and there they would stay for a few months. And every day part of the ritual was to come and fork down some hay as feed for the animals. And at the same time you'd milk any as appropriate. And then of course the muck would build up. And in the spring you'd let the cattle back out onto the pastures, and you would fork all the muck out across the grass to promote fresh growth. That was the basic cycle. But as well as the food management, of course, there was the milking to be done. And so regularly a farmer would come out every day, often three times a day, with like a small tank on his back, go to barn one, milk the cows, pop it in the tank, move on to barn two, barn three, barn four, barn five. And then back home. And it was a pretty tough existence. And they're pretty well all redundant now, but they were certainly working 50 years ago. There's a good example of where you'd load the hay in.
Hello.
Yeah.
And here we are in the village of Muker, M-U-K-E-R. It's a very pretty little place. And indeed, here we have the description of a barn. And reference to the meadows as well. I'll follow you, Molly.
Did you want to come in here? No.
No, I don't think so, thank you. I think we're okay.
Welcome.
Thank you. Built in the 1860s as a reading room for local people. In practice, men only, it says. Okay. Mode of transport has changed, but a lot of the rest of this looks the same. And here we are. Part of the village, by the shops and the ice creams. So I think we'll wind it up there. As ever, thank you so much for watching. Do hit the subscribe button if you'd like to. There's plenty more coming. Bye now.